Hello friends, so today we are going to derive the formula for Laplace transform of sine hat or hyperbolic sine of at. Now to derive the formula of Laplace transform of hyperbolic sine at, we are going to make use of definition of Laplace transform. Now what is definition of Laplace transform? So let's start. So I want to find out Laplace transform of hyperbolic sine at. So we'll start with the definition. So here I'll say by the definition of Laplace transform, we have Laplace of a function of t is equal to integration 0 to infinity e raised to minus st f of t, that is function of t with respect to t. Now let's use this definition to find out the Laplace of hyperbolic sine at. So Laplace of hyperbolic sine at equal to, so if I'll compare this hyperbolic sine at with this Laplace of f of t, then we can say that this f of t is equal to hyperbolic sine at. So here on the right hand side also we'll substitute f of t as hyperbolic sine at. So this will become e raised to minus st hyperbolic sine at into dt, that is with respect to t. Now to get the value of integration of e raised to minus st hyperbolic sine at with respect to t, we will convert that hyperbolic sine function in exponential function with the help of one formula. Now what is the formula? The formula is hyperbolic sine of theta is equal to e raised to theta minus e raised to minus theta upon 2. Now if I compare this hyperbolic sine at term with this sine h theta, then this at is equal to theta. So now in this formula we will substitute theta as at. So we'll get is equal to integration 0 to infinity e raised to minus st into e raised to at minus e raised to minus at upon 2 into dt, that is with respect to t. Now here I'll take 1 upon 2 which is constant outside the integration, so here we'll get 1 by 2 integration 0 to infinity, and now I'll multiply this bracket with e raised to minus st term. So e raised to minus st into e raised to at will become e raised to minus s plus a into t. So we are adding the exponents. Next the middle sign is negative. E raised to minus st into e raised to minus at will give us e raised to minus s minus a into t dt. Now let's find out the integration of these two terms. So here we'll get 1 by 2 as it is, and the integration of e raised to minus st plus a into t is e raised to minus s plus a into t upon derivative of minus s plus a into t, and that derivative is minus s plus a. Minus here we'll get e raised to minus s minus a into t upon minus s minus a, which is the derivative of minus s minus a into t, and we have limit from 0 to infinity. Now before substituting the limit, let's observe the terms. So here in the first term, if I want to substitute the upper limit, that is infinity, then here we'll get this minus s plus a into infinity, and infinity into the finite term is equal to infinity. So e raised to infinity will give us infinity. It means in the answer we will get one term as infinity, and when we will add anything in infinity or subtract something from infinity, then also the final answer will be infinity. Hence infinity is not acceptable. Therefore what we have to do is, By anyhow, we have to convert this power as minus infinity. Now why? Because e raised to minus infinity is equal to 0. So by doing that, we can get value as 0, which is the finite value. Now, to make the power or the exponent as minus infinity, I need to take minus sign out of these brackets. So let's see the first term. So in the first term, if I'll take minus sign outside, then this s will become positive in the bracket and this a will become negative in the bracket. So we'll get is equal to 1 by 2 inside the bracket e raised to minus sign outside s minus a by t upon minus s plus a. Next, middle sign negative. Here, if I'll take negative sign outside, then we'll get s plus a in the bracket. So this will become e raised to minus s plus a into t upon minus of s plus a from 0 to infinity. Now, here, this minus minus will become plus. So we'll get 1 by 2 e raised to minus of s minus a into t upon minus s plus a minus minus plus e raised to minus of s plus a into t upon s plus a from 0 to infinity. And now we will substitute upper limit and lower limit. So the upper limit is infinity. Here we'll get 1 by 2 into e raised to t is infinity. So we'll get minus infinity upon minus s plus a plus e raised to minus infinity upon s plus a. Middle sign is negative. Now let's substitute the lower limit. Lower limit is 0. So 0 into the finite term is 0. So e raised to 0 upon minus s plus a plus e raised to 0 upon s plus a. Now, as I told you that e raised to minus infinity is 0. So we will get this first term as 0 minus this will become 1 upon, because e raised to 0 is 1, minus s plus a. This will become minus plus minus e raised to 0 is 1 upon s plus a. Now, I can take this minus sign outside the bracket, that will become minus half, and in the bracket we will get 1 upon, this is a minus s plus 1 upon a plus s. So I'm just writing the first term as second, that is negative term second and the positive term first. So here by doing the cross multiplication we will get minus 1 by 2 into a plus s plus a minus s upon a minus s into a plus s. Now here this positive s and negative s will be cancelled. We will get a plus a, that is 2a. So because of this minus n, we will get minus 2a upon 2. And this is a minus s a plus s, that is the formula of a square minus s square. Now again 2 and 2 is cancelled. So in numerator we got a. And now I will shift this negative sign in the denominator, and because of that this negative s square will become positive s square and this positive a square will become negative a square. So we got the value of integration as a upon s square minus a square. So we were finding the Laplace of sine h a t, and now I can say that it is equal to a upon s square minus a square. Thank you.